everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about satellite communication trainer and its order code is 10203B. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. Now let's have the component description of the kit. So this is the transmitter. Here we are having power LED section, then this is the AV input section, then this is the signal generator section. Here amplitude adjustment port is there. Then frequency adjustment port is there. This is the square wave generator. This is the sine wave generator port. Then this is the signal input. Then transmitter amplifier section. Then this is the transmitting antenna. Then this is the mic input section. Then this is the RS-232 input section. Then this is the frequency selector. We are having switch for the frequency selector. Then this is the 7 segment display. Here the channel number is being displayed and we are having 1 to 8 channels. Then this is the ground section. Then this is the receiver kit. Here power LED section is there, AV output is there, low pass filter section is there, comparator section is there, and this is the port adjustment. Then this is the signal output, then this is the receiver amplifier, then this is the receiver antenna, then this is the ground, this is the RS-232 output. Then this is the frequency selector switch and there also we are having 7 segment display and here channel number is being displayed and we are having channels from 1 to 8. Then this is the speaker output section. Then this is the transponder. Here we are having receiver section and the transmitter section and here we are having two antennas. So this is the satellite unit. Now let's perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study and establish signal generator link between transmitter and receiver. So for that we have to do the connections first. So we have to connect these antennas on the kit. So the transmitter antenna at the transmitter kit, the receiving antenna at the receiver kit, and these two antenna at the transponder. So we just have to slide it like this. So that is how you can remove it and there is a hook present on the antenna. So you just have to slide it on the lock section and just you have to place the antenna like this and you have to connect this BNC cable on the CN1 and CN2 and other sections. So that is how you can remove the BNC cable and you can connect it like this. So that is how all the antennas will be connected on the kit. Now we will switch on the transmitter, receiver and transponder. So we have to connect the main supply with the transmitter, receiver and transponder. Now we will switch on the kit. So when we switch on the kit, we can see that the channel number is being displayed on the kit, on the transmitter section also, on the receiver section also and the transponder section also. So now we have to select the channels. Now we can select the channel by using the frequency selector switch. So firstly we will select the channel at transmitter kit. So here on the transmitter kit by using the frequency selector switch, I can select the channel number from 1 to 8. So let's suppose we are selecting channel 2 and now we will select the channel number at receiver of the transponder. So here also we have to select the same channel as we have selected in the transmitter. So here also I have to select 2. Now I will move to the receiver end and now here by using the frequency selector switch I am selecting a channel except 2. I can select any channel from 1 to 8. So I am selecting channel 1. So now at the transmitter of the transponder, I am selecting channel 1. So here also I have to select the channel similar to the receiver. So that is how channel selection is done. So some of the points we have to keep in mind while performing this experiment are channel numbers of satellite transmitter and transponder receiver must be same. Then second point, channel numbers of satellite receiver and transponder transmitter must be same. Third point, channel numbers of satellite transmitter and receiver must not be same. So these are some of the points we should keep in mind while performing this experiment. Now we will connect the transmitter and receiver by using the patch codes. So firstly we have to give sine wave as an input to the transmitter. So here we will connect sine port to the signal input with this 2mm patch code like this. Then at the receiver we will connect signal output to the input of low pass filter like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the DSO and we have to take both the channels, channel 1 and channel 2. So now firstly we will connect the channel 1 at the transmitter end. So we will connect the ground to the ground of the transmitter and this wire of the patch code to the sine port like this. And now we will connect the channel 2 at the receiver kit. So we will connect the ground to the ground like this. And now we will connect the other port at the out of the low pass filter. So here on the DSO you can see that both the signals we are getting. So at channel 1 we are having our transmitting signal and at the channel 2 we are having our receiving signal. And we can adjust the amplitude and frequency by using the port that is provided on the transmitter. So here when I vary the amplitude you can see that the amplitude get reduced, and when I rotate the amplitude adjustment port at clockwise direction the amplitude of the waveform increase. And we can also vary the frequency. So here when I am rotating the frequency adjustment port anti-clockwise you can see that the waveform behaves like this, and when we rotate the frequency adjustment port clockwise then this is the waveform which we get. So that is how this experiment is performed. And this is the analog signal transmission and reception. Now we will see the transmission and reception of digital signal. So for that we will connect this signal input to the square input of the transmitter. So here on the DSO you can see that we just shifted the signal input from sine to square so that we can get digital signal. And now we can again vary the amplitude and we can see the variation on the amplitude, and we can also vary the frequency. So here when you stop the waveform you can see the waveform clearly. So at channel 1 we are having our transmitting signal and at channel 2 we are receiving our signal. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study and communicate voice signal between transmitter and receiver through satellite transponder. So for that, the channel selection will be same as the above experiment, that is at the transmitter gate, the channel which we have selected should be same as the receiver of the transponder. So here we have selected channel number 2 at transmitter gate, so we have to select the same channel number 2 at receiver of the transponder. Similarly, at the receiver gate, the channel which we have selected is channel 1. You can select any channel between 1 to 8 except the channel 2 which you have selected at the transmitter. So here we have selected channel number 1, so we have to select the same channel at the transponder of the transmitter. So the channel which we have selected is 1 and it is same as the receiver. So the channel selection will be same as the earlier experiment. Now we will do the connections. So firstly we will connect the mic out section at the signal input of the transmitter like this. Then we will connect the speaker input to the signal output like this. So that is how the patch cords are connected. Now we will connect the mic and the headphones. So at the speaker out section, we will connect the earplugs or headphones. So that is how you can connect the headphone or earplugs at the speaker out. And now we will connect the mic at the input section of transmitter. So at mic input block, we will connect the mic at input of the transmitter like this. So now when we switch on the mic like this and when we speak anything in the mic, we can hear the voice at the headphone. So when you speak anything in the mic, you can hear the voice at the headphone. So that is how you can perform this experiment. You can also perform the audio video satellite link by using this kit. So here on the transmitter section, we are having AV input. So here we are having audio jack, then video input jack, then at the receiver we are having video out and audio out jack. So by connecting it to the DVD writer and by connecting a TV monitor, we can see the video and we can have the audio also. So that is how we can also perform this experiment on the kit. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.